Do you know how macOS is all protective and limiting? You can't open unfamiliar downloaded apps, can't play around with configs beyond what Apple allows, and don't even get me started about the mess in the notification center. But what if I told you there's one tool that bans macOS and make it do whatever you want? Send alerts, pop windows, tell applications what to do, automate quite literally whatever you want, with code from your terminal the way it should be. Hammerspoon? No, not that, is an amazing library revealing an API around macOS and also packs pre-built customizations called spoons. You get to write in code anything you can think of. Sounds good, right? But there are some issues. Old unfunctioning spoons, APIs that break with every new OS release, and other finicky stuff that's so familiar to Mac users. Personally, I was on my own mission. I wanted to build myself a calendar meeting alert. If you've been following this channel for a while, you might have seen me try doing the same with Tmux. But whatever I threw at it, I couldn't get things to work. So before getting into this glorious story, let's rewind a little and start using Hammerspoon from scratch while skipping all the hurdles it pops. You can get a pretty good idea of Hammerspoon's capabilities from hammerspoon.org. The 10-year-old website has been around enough time to answer most of the FAQ, but we're going to go easy and cut through to the tasty bits, or bytes. Anyway, Hammerspoon was just released in version 1.0 to celebrate its 10th birthday. Super exciting! Let's get it installed. Use the binary, Nix or whatever you like. Today we're going simple. Brew install Hammerspoon and when it's done, fire it up. What you see immediately is the Hammerspoon debug log. Very useful feature, but we'll get to that. You can pop the documentation with all the API options, but most importantly, when you're just getting started, make sure you've enabled the accessibility permissions to let Hammerspoon do its thing. Okay, moving over to the terminal. Let's get this thing going. Using the Hammer menu on top, you can do all kinds of stuff. One of them is opening the config. I'm not going to do that because, believe it or not, the default config file doesn't sit in .config. And since I like my .files laid out in their own directory, which is in sync with .config using stow, more on that in the video above, we need to make some changes. Naturally, I don't have home/.hammerspoon, but if you're going to use the defaults, this is where you're going to find your config and have everything set up. Here's my .config/hammerspoon properly sitting like all other .files in its own path where Hammerspoon is only a symlink, created with stow, just the way I like it. But will Hammerspoon conform? Well, not that simple. You'd have to run this command to make it redirect the configuration path. Quite annoying if you ask me, but it only has to be done once. Plus, I'm leaving this in the description, and to make sure no one's missing anything, if you head over to my .files repo, I'm adding this in the README under Hammerspoon subdirectory, just in case. Right, we're all set, let's start the work. Like every good Lua project, we start with an init.lua. AGES stands for Hammerspoon, and while my language server refuses to recognize it, when Hammerspoon loads it, there's no issue. If you do want to keep the LSP warnings to a minimum, just declare AGES above as a global. One of the most common uses for the hammer is wrapping something with a key binding. To do that, we used ages.hotkey.bind, then an array of modifiers followed by the key itself, and lastly a function that's bound to the combination. In this instance, I'm taking the command and alt, or option for you Mac purists. Now, before running our code, another concept that's important to introduce is spoons. Basically, a library that serves some kind of a function and can be loaded into Hammerspoon. When you install it, it already comes with a structure for spoons that you can start using right away. There's a clock and an app launcher, yes, another macOS app launcher. You can interact with Asana, Homebrew, Bing, and the clipboard and other stuff. To demonstrate a spoon, let's go with the aclock. To add aclock, we run ages.loadSpoon and the name of the spoon as input. Create the spoons directory in your path. This has already been created for you if you haven't changed the default like I did earlier. And now we have to get it. The simplest way is to just follow the link and download it. A downloaded spoon comes wrapped in a zip file, and once extracted, if you double click it, it'll get removed from the downloads and installed into your Hammerspoon path. Not bad. If you're wondering what's inside a spoon, well, it's just another init.lua file and a JSON documentation. Rarely a couple more files, but that's generally it. Let's call spoon.aclock and use its toggle show method. See if it works. Let's use the menu above to reload the config, and don't worry, we're fixing that too in just a bit. With our new config loaded, command alt C, and there's a weird blue clock floating in midair. How about doing something a bit more useful than that? Instead of relying on a spoon, let's go straight to the API. One of my personal favorites is the ability to control and manipulate applications. Launch or Focus may sound familiar because it suggests an app launcher. If you've been subscribed to this channel for a while, you may have heard me yap about SKHD, Thin Aerospace, but now there's yet another option. Not sure I'm switching, but it's there. Hammerspoon can control everything, including applications. So let's create a new binding. Same modifiers, but this time with A to fire up Arc and be able to switch over to the browser for docs. With ajs.application.launcherfocus, I can provide Arc as an input, and yeah, Hammerspoon can be your next app launcher. Does it work? Yep, there's Arc. All right, making progress. Let's take this a step further. If you want to take on Hammerspoon yourself, I highly recommend going through the Getting Started section. It'll help familiarize yourself with most of the essentials. For example, one of the things that were extremely appealing to me were interacting with application menus, kind of like running browser automation. You can pop any application and tell it to run anything within its menus. I found a lot of uses for that, including the screen capture you're seeing right now running with QuickTime. Let's see an example with Arc. If we go to Help, there's a Getting Started option. Let's use that. This is what it looks like if you click it directly. So, using the same bind we did earlier, we're going to add a local var named Arc, and that's using Hammerspoon's App Finder API to load its menu. With Arc, I can now use the Select Menu Item API and send a set of help followed by Getting Started. What do you say? Going to work? Let's see. Command Alt A and voila. Maybe it's just the nerd inside me that's so excited right now, but onto something actually useful. Instead of having to reload the config using the UI, let's set a key binding for that. With Alt R, we're going to bind a function that runs hjs.reload, simple as that. But it's not enough to just run it. With hjs alert show, we can pop a custom notification on screen and set it to whatever we want. So let's print config loaded into the screen and rerun this thing. And there you go, config loaded, middle screen in your face. This can be annoying at times, but it can also be a great way to remind yourself of something that needs attention. Remember my mission from earlier? I'm trying to build myself a better meeting notifications working with Google Calendar. So naturally, I first went to AppleScript trying to interact with a local calendar on my Mac. Long story short, it didn't work, no matter how much I was fighting with it. So I did what every sensible person would have done in my position. I built a Golang application to authenticate with Google, get me the calendar meetings straight to the command line. This way, I'd be able to pop them as notifications and play with them however I like, or so I thought. The wonderful Cal app can be found on my GitHub under the name GoMaCal. It's the best I could come up with in a span of 10 seconds, deal with it. Here's how it works. You run the CLI to get every meeting of the day, or add the flag minus minus next and give it a time period. I don't actually want it to print anything when there are no meetings, just an empty string, so I'm getting rid of that. Now, because we're pros, let's make this a spoon, so that you, my friend, can use it at home. It's not that fancy, all it means that instead of holding it in your init.lua, you create something.spoon, and add another init.lua inside that. There are some conventions to follow, but it's not critical. My spoon takes a path for calendar app binary as input and then sends the start method command. I'll shorten the scan time to 5 seconds just so we don't sit here and wait for a notification to pop. And okay, it's go time, creating yet another meeting I shouldn't be on. And there we are. Look at all those notifications. Don't worry, it doesn't have to be a huge list, you can configure it however you want. But wait, here's where things get really cool. Or at least I think so. The calendar app parses the meeting link in the calendar, so that if there is one, you can actually go straight in. Check this out, adding a quick Google Meet link. Save, let's check the newly incoming notification and hello. Now we can make it more obvious by using the alert API that shoots notifications on screen that you can't really ignore. Let's make myself aware by popping something on screen and there we are. Obvious enough? What do you think? There are so many other interesting APIs to explore and play with, I feel like I'm in a candy store. With Hammerspoon at your side, the options are endless. I just finished configuring QuickTime to pop, then have Hammerspoon navigate on its own to file start a new movie, because QuickTime is so annoying when it starts. Now I have a shortcut to do all that for me. I'm not stopping there. Already thinking of better window management, maybe even turning macOS into a little automation server. Anyway, that's all great, but it would be a painful experience to configure without NeoVim handling the code. Watch this video next for an amazing configuration covering everything you need from scratch. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.